Kevin, obviously I know you fit into the category of the proverbial old white guy. I don't know your exact age, but I would say you're probably more in that category than some of the, you know, the minority categories. What made you interested in being a part of the council and getting involved to this extent?
Well, like I mentioned earlier, I'm hard of hearing, so a disability is one of those sort of sections of diversity that we've talked about for the council, and because of that, being an invisible disability, deafness, I think it's really important that we are aware that diversity goes way beyond you know, gender and skin color, you know, ethnicity. It goes, you know, it just goes as far as you want it, really. It's just about differences and bringing those differences together, and having those kind of differences in the industry can only benefit everybody. I mean, there's so many studies that have proven that how more productive a diverse team can be. So there's a real business case actually behind why anybody should get involved in this and try to create more diversity in the industry.
Okay. Charmaine, I don't know if you've seen some of our research related to the state of the industry, but one of the articles that we published related to that talked about the demographics of the folks that answered the survey. And the reason I use the term old white guys is because that was in the headline of what we had published, that primarily the folks that are answering our surveys and, you know, I guess are making the decisions in this industry remain those old white guys. Are you seeing progress in you know, kind of having more decision makers that are of diverse backgrounds and, you know, different ethnicities and, you know, and females in particular?
In terms of answering surveys and participation, or
just decision makers in specifically in the AV industry, and, you know, having people, you know, be the people that the you know, folks turn to when they have, you know, a question that they need answered, or, you know, a project that they want to get done.
Progress is slow, and this is why. The progress is slow because although now we're starting to recognize more the diversity in this industry, it's still a matter of valuing that person's feedback and valuing what their input and their contribution is in the industry. So yes, we're here, but for example, Kevin is hearing impaired. You know, in our industry, we make a living out of allowing workplace, you know, inclusion by allowing everyone disabled not to collaborate. Although that's our industry to design and build that, we don't always factor in those workers who happen to be impaired in some way as to how, you know, a collaboration room should go. Like you said, it's still a lot of those old white guys who they know they're there, they know they're present, but they're not going to them within their organization, say, well, you know, let's talk to him. We know we have to make this ADA compliant. Should we make it ADA compliant? And they really don't. They have workers like that. They really don't factor in their input. It's the same as being a minority. Like not too long ago, I had an incident at a company where we were responding to a big major RFP that incorporated broadcast and AV equipment. And I had expressed to my colleague, since I had that broadcast integration knowledge when I knew he was working on it, I said, well, do you know this manufacturer? We should get to know this manufacturer and maybe you should reach out to this person. He said, no, not necessary, not important. Responded to the RFP. After that, it's like, oh my gosh, we're getting it. What do I do? I said, well, did you ever reach out to this person? No, I said, okay, you need to, because you need to know X, Y, and Z. And he's just scrambling at the last minute, pulling me in. I'm like, I can't help you. I can't help you right now. It's like, well, I said, if you had listened to me when I told you in the beginning to get familiar with this and not discounted what I told you, you would have been in better shape. So that's the problem that exists. Yes, there's diversity in our industry. It's all about those workers coming together and including everyone's feedback and contribution. It's including it and not discounting it. That's a very big problem. And so I call it, my job is to call it out for myself and to help everyone know how to determine when that is and how to call it out in a nice professional manner, but make sure that it's noted. You have the workers here, you have the contribution, use it. Don't exclude it. So that's where I see the problem, the knot in the system is.